Hi everyone, Nikki here. Today I want to show you how to create a simple form in Canva, download it as a PDF file, and then add fillable form fields to that PDF for free using a fabulous new tool which I've just discovered. There's no need to have Canva Pro for this tutorial, but if you would like to upgrade for free for 45 days and have the benefit of thousands of beautiful photographs and Canva Pro elements, all you need to do is click on the link which I will leave in the description box below. Hi and welcome to my channel. If you want to learn how to successfully market your brand online, be sure to hit that subscribe button and bell so you're notified each time I publish a new video. So if you're ready to get started, let's dive into Canva. So first things first, you want to start creating the document that you want to add the fillable form fields to. I've already made a mock-up of a new client form that I know a lot of freelancers and virtual assistants send out as part of their onboarding process. You can see I've already added some subtitles and some details onto the form. Let me just make background a little bit more transparent so that the text pops out a little bit more. Okay, so starting from the top, I'm going to show you how to add spaces where your client can then fill in their details once the form is finished. Essentially, you're going to be creating a really simple table in Canva. If you're using columns like this, very simple columns, you might want to first of all drag a marker to the center point so that you can see where it lies. So this document is 21 centimetres wide, so this centre point is going to be 10.5. So I'm going to zoom in slightly using this new zoom tool. And starting from the top, I'm going to start adding the spaces for the text. To do that, head over to the sidebar, click on Elements, find the subcategory Lines and Shapes, and click on Align, which will bring it up onto your template here. I don't know if you're already aware of this, but Canva has introduced a really simple new way of making a line, which is wonderful if you want to make a particularly thin line. So I'm just going to click on the line to select it. This will bring up the line formatting menu in the top left-hand corner of your Canva desktop. Here you can choose the color of your line, the line weight, the style of your line, and how you want the line to be ended, so you can end it with arrows, a circle, square, and so on. And you can even animate the line. But for now, I just want a single black line. I'm going to drag it into place, and I'm going to hover my mouse over the end button, and you'll see that the cursor turns into a very thin cross, and I'm just going to resize the line, okay? To make the line really thin, I'm going to click on the line weight tool, and slide the button along the slider until I can see a number 1 in the box. Alternatively, you can just type 1 into the box and hit return. Fabulous. Now I don't need to do this process all over again. All I need to do is select the line, click on duplicate, and then drag the line to where I want it to be in my form. I'm just going to do the rest. Scrolling down a bit, in the next section, I'm going to ask my client to select their level of expertise from a drop-down menu. I can't create a drop-down menu in Canva, so I'm going to leave this little space blank for the time being. So make sure you keep watching because I'm going to show you exactly how to create a drop-down menu very shortly. Next, we come to the signature part. I'm going to add a line for the names, so I'll go back up to the top, click on the line, click duplicate, and drag it down into position. Do the same for the next side. Okay. And I'm going to do the same for the date and sign spaces. Perfect. That's really starting to take shape. Before I download my file, I'm just going to hyperlink my business URL. So to do that, if you don't know already, select the text, go to the top right-hand corner of your Canva toolbar, click on the link icon and add the URL. Now just click on Apply. Please note that clickable links only work in PDF format. Now that's completely finished, and I'm going to head on up to the Canva toolbar, click on the downward arrow. I'm going to select my file type as PDF standard, since I don't want to print it, and click on download. And now I want you to type in this URL into your browsers. If you watched my tutorial last week, I used this tool to show you how to convert a PDF into a Word document. If you missed out, don't worry, I'll leave the link to the video in the description box below. DocFly has a free version and will allow you to create, edit, and convert up to 3 PDF files per month. After that, you'll have to upgrade to the paid account, but at just £5.99 a month, it really isn't expensive. So you're going to upload your Canva PDF here. You can also drag and drop it into this space. I'm going to find my file and I'm going to drag it into that space there. Once uploaded, you'll be taken to the DocFly dashboard where you can see your file just here. Next, you're going to put a tick in this little box here and then click on the downward arrow next to the Edit tab to bring up the editing menu. And from this menu, you're going to select PDF Form Creator. You'll find all the editing tools in this menu right at the top. So now what we're going to do is we're going to add form fields to our form. Let's start off by adding a text field. Click on it once. Next, you can select how the text is going to look when it's typed into the form fields. So I would select a font that's easy to read. So let's stick with Helvetica. And you use a font size that's going to be clear and legible. You can change the text color if you like, but I'm going to stick with what I've got. Next, I'm going to place my cursor where I want the text field to be. Click on it once. Now I can edit the size of the text box by just dragging out one of these corner buttons. If you make a mistake, don't worry, you can delete the text field by clicking on the trash icon. You can also move the text field around by clicking on this icon just here. And now I'm going to go ahead and add the rest of the text form fields. Perfect. Scrolling down, now here's where we're going to add our drop-down menu. So go to the editing tools at the top and find drop-down field. Click on it once, place your cursor where you want the drop-down menu to appear on your form, click to place it. I'm going to just make it slightly bigger, move it down just a little bit. Excellent. Now to add the choices to your drop-down menu, go to the right-hand side of the form and you'll find some editing tools. You're going to add the choices into this box here. So I'm asking my clients to select their Canva expertise. So I'm going to add beginner and then click on add, intermediate, superstar. So those are the three choices I've added to my drop-down menu. And that's all there is to it. If you want to make sure that your client fills in all the information that you want, go to the right-hand side of the form field menu and put a check in this required box. Scrolling down, we're now going to add the signature form fields. So for the name, I'm going to add a text field. Now for the date, I'm going to click on the date field. And as we did before, I'm going to place my cursor where I want the date to be added and just click once. If you want the date to appear in a particular format, you can change it right here. Perfect. And now for the signature form field. And again, I'm going to go to the top and find signature field. I'm going to place my cursor where I want the signature to appear. And there we are. Now, when it comes to adding the signatures to your form, you as the form creator can actually sign it within DocFly by placing your cursor within the box here, going to the right-hand side toolbar, and clicking on Insert Signature. So you can actually type your signature into this box here, change the font color if you like, or you can draw your signature, or upload it if you have a digital signature already created. If you need another signature, say for instance your client's signature, all you need to do is save your file, download it using the purple button here, and then send your PDF to your client for signature using a tool like HelloSign. This is what your gorgeous file will look like once you've downloaded it. Look how easy it is to annotate and add the text into the form fields. So now you can go ahead and create beautiful fillable forms using Canva and my fabulous new discovery, DocFly. If you'd like to learn more about HelloSign, I'll leave you the link in the resources section below. Coming up next is a link to last week's tutorial and a link to my playlist of Canva tips and tricks. I will see you in the next video.